The image of God as a father is one that is very common throughout Scripture. Jesus obviously uses it the most in the New Testament, bringing that idea very much into our vocabulary as Christians, this idea of God as the Father, as our Heavenly Father. And I think when we're sitting here on this Father's Day, that for some people, this is a bit of a difficult metaphor to take. At the time that this was being made, that these verses were said and written down and everything, the families tended to always kind of stick together. There was less divorce. There was less ways to get divorced as well. And it was, you typically didn't see as many split families or as many sort of messy sort of situations as we do nowadays. Now, of course, part of that is that we're looking back through the lens of history. And so if that stuff was there, we're getting maybe seeing a few cases here and there and being mentioned in various books or things written by people back then, but not really as prevalent as what we like see today, where, if you're from my generation at least, and I believe even older generations as well, you probably know at least one person who has been through a divorce or has a very bad relationship with their father. And I think that this is actually where this imagery actually works even better. And I know that's a little bit weird to sort of say. I just sort of said that this is a metaphor that a lot of people struggle with, but there's this other sort of side of it, which is this idea that God is our father. So if you've lost a father, if you don't have that father anymore, you still do have one in heaven, and you can rely on him to be that dad for you that maybe you don't have or you haven't had ever since. And even for those of us who do have fathers, who do have that sort of, who have good relationships with them as well, we still also benefit from this as well. And I think on this Father's Day that we should keep that in mind, as well as giving love to our dads that are around us. Showing them that they're appreciated for all the wisdom that they give us and for all the life lessons they have taught us. I think we should also be thankful to God today as well, for being our Heavenly Father and doing the same things for us. So that is all I have for you this week. I'm going to wish you all out there a very happy Father's Day. If you are a father, enjoy your day. If not, well, call your dad if you can, and if it's appropriate, obviously. I will see you all next week. I'm going to go ahead and leave you all with our final worship song today.